We're going to try to do this in one take. The idea, by the how we make art more better for everyone on the planet by the Dryer Bothers. Okay, way back in time, before Cake or, sorry, the band Cake, but I think even you too, right after we were cavemen, when there was Madonna, it was 1980. In 1980, if you were an author and you had an idea for a book, you were in a tough spot. You only had one book. So what you needed to do is go to a publisher. You'd be like, I have a book. And he'd be cool. He'd be like, cool, I have a lot of money. And a lot of money in 1980 is what you needed in order to make a book. Because in 1980, you needed to have a factory to produce books. You needed to put the books onto trucks to spread them around. You had to put them on boats to get overseas. You had to get them on planes to send them to China. And finally, you had to sell the books to customers in actual bookstores with actual booksellers. And customers would have to pay money for the books. And customers could have to pay as much as $19, oh sorry, $20. That's how you write 20 in the US for a book. But you had to pay all those people. And finally, the publisher got more and more money and actually wound up with the book. The publisher got the book and the writer in exchange got a little bit of money per book. Now, of course, a little bit of money per book could mean that the author got showered with money if the whole world read the book. However, the whole world would spend way more on the book than the author got. The rest of the money would go to all those other things, the plane and the cars. Now, that's it for 1980. Let's fast forward to 1982. In 1982, aliens visited planet Earth. They had a present. They were like, I like Earthlings. Oh, let's wait for it. I like Earthlings. Yes. Me too, but I don't like their governments or their businesses. We should help them. So they went looking how to help us, or for a person to help, and they found him, and they said, we like you. Yes, we think your movies are funny about alien invasions. The idea you could win is absolutely ridiculous. Here you go. Have this. This will fix your governments and companies. How? Just invest in it. You'll see. And then they gave the humans the internet and left in their spaceship. Whoa, said the human. Okay, now, let's fast forward to 2012. We have the internet now, we have iPads. Now, if you're an author and you have an idea for a book, you're in a good place. Well, sort of. At least it's easy for your book to get out to the world. You just upload it to the internet, and then everybody can share, there's Australia, everybody can share your book all over the world. And everybody gets to read your book. And because your book is so very awesome, everybody loves your book. Right? Because they all can get it for free. So now, as an author, you have a lot of love, but unfortunately, you don't have a house, or food, or a car, or a wedding ring for some foolish lady you're going to convince to marry you at some point in your life. So, you go back to the publisher, and give them your book. Okay. Let's put this into perspective. I want to give these numbers for you, so you can like really see how this works. He's not an author, he's a movie maker, but it's the same thing, right? Digital media. Let's take James Cameron, for example. James Cameron made the movie Avatar, right? He made the movie Avatar. From this, he made $350 million, which is a ridiculous amount of money, right? The movie itself cost about $500 million. So that makes a combined total of $850 million cost for the movie. That's what it cost to make the movie. Now remember, that could have been given to the world for free, right? But it wasn't. Because of the way we have our laws set up, we actually spent a combined total of $2.7 billion. $1 billion. That we did not need to spend. We could have just had that for free. But unfortunately, we as planet are retarded and prefer to give our money to the companies that helped make these laws that force us to spend this money to see James Cameron's film. Okay, now in the future it's not going to work that way because how can we let it work that way forever, right? In the future, if James Cameron wants to make Avatar, Avatar 27, he will ask the world for money. The world will give him money and then he'll give the world The movie, which means the world saves $2.7 billion, which you can spend on doctors, hover cars, and holographic watches, which display whatever they want, and also more art. Look, more art means more competition, and that means better art. Also, it'll get more audience-specific. When 20th Century Fox targets population, it targets the entire planet, which is dumb, right? I mean, the planet's dumb. It's not dumb to do that, which is dumb. In the future, if James Cameron makes Avatar 27, he can target a very specific audience, right? Because that audience will be impassioned and will be more likely to give more money towards his project. The future is now. Kickstarter is a company that allows the public to fund creative projects. If you take Kickstarter and you combine it with a Creative Commons license, you can do the future now for legal. You can pay the author to release the book and then give it away for free to everyone. The author leaves with the money that he received, or they received, for the book, and then the world gets it for free. What that means, you can go to www.kickstarter.com to check out Kickstarter. What that means is that The Fast and the Furious never needed to get made. The Firefly could go on forever, right? Deadwood would never have been canceled. Stanley Kubrick could have made every movie that he ever wanted, right? and we would never wind up with horrific things like 2012. Because in 2012, we can share music and books and movies for free. We just need to pay the authors before that happens. The creators, before they give it away. And do away with intellectual property. And everyone's happier. The aliens are happy, the author's happy, the world's happy. Yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the idea, and please come over and check out the book that we are going to publish in just this way. It's at the Little Red Bird book.blogspot.com, and yeah, give us a Kickstarter, even just a dollar or two. You can get a hard copy of the book, but the ebooks are going to be free for the entire planet. Yeah, that's it. That's the idea. Oh, there are going to be a bunch of different languages too. German, French, Polish, Spanish, I don't know why I thought it was Spanish before. So there you have it. Bye. Thanks again for watching.